Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. Episode number 9 of the 120 Days to Jam Chemistry with Flash Isaac. In this episode, we are going strictly to questions under chemical combination. Volume of oxygen, 150 cm cube. Volume of hydrogen, 150 cm cube. Hydrogen and oxygen, H2 plus O2. And we know that if hydrogen and oxygen are sparked, we are definitely getting water. So, H2O. And the temperature actually shows that at 100 degrees Celsius, water should be gas. So we are dealing with gases, water gas, not water liquid or water solid. It makes sense now. In water, from here we have two hydrogen, which is balanced because we have two hydrogen here. Here we have oxygen. Meanwhile, here we have only one oxygen. We therefore need to increase oxygen so that oxygen will be two. How do we increase oxygen? Don't touch here in balancing of equation. No. Touch here. Two. If here is two, oxygen is balanced, but hydrogen has been increased by 2. To account for that, we put 2 here. So this is the equation for hydrogen reacting with oxygen. 4 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen, 2 times 2. 2 oxygen, 2 times 2, 2 oxygen. So we balance the equation. You've added another thing to your dictionary. When you balance hydrogen and oxygen, you get 2H2 plus O2. To give you 2H2O. Then carbon monoxide and oxygen, you get, was it 2CO plus O2 to give you 2CO2. That should be something like that. Now, this means that 2 moles of hydrogen is required to spark with 1 mole of oxygen to give us 2 moles of water. And I told you that stoichiometry compares what should be and what is. What should be is the formula. When you have a balanced equation, the mole ratio tells you what is supposed to happen. The mass also tells you what is supposed to happen. This, for the mass, remember I told you that mole can also be as mass. 2 moles, 2 ratio 1, ratio 2. The mass of 2H2 is 4. The mass of hydrogen is 1. 1 times 2 is 2 times 2, 4. The mass of 1 mole of oxygen is 16 times 2, that is 32. The mass of 2 moles of water, 1 mole of water is 18 grams. 18 times 2, that should give you 36 if I am correct. So, another thing that should be is that we need 4 grams of hydrogen to react with 32 grams of oxygen to give us 36 grams of water. This is what should be. Now, what is what we are given in the question. In the question, we are given volume, 150 cm cube of hydrogen. One of hydrogen, 150 cm cube. Oxygen, 50 cm cube. Oxygen, 50 cm cube. This is what is. Let's compare what is to what should be. Let's start with here. Hydrogen is 150 cm³. If hydrogen is reacting with oxygen in the ratio 2:1 and 2 is 150, what we want be? If 2 is 150, 1 is supposed to be 150 divided by 2, 75. This is what it's supposed to be. Why? If 2 is 150 cm³, 2 more of water will also be 150 cm³. This is supposed to be, but look at the question. They only gave us 50 cm³ of oxygen. What does that mean? The oxygen they gave us is not enough. Since the oxygen they gave us is not enough, we can therefore not use all the hydrogen. Oxygen will determine the product form. It is the limiting reagent. Hydrogen is in excess. So, what should be the right thing? Since we are only given 50 cm³ of oxygen, which means 1 is 50 cm³, 2 should be 50 times 2, that is 100 cm³. 2 here should also be 100 cm³. Therefore, 50 cm³ of H2 will not react. It is gone. This is what we need for the reaction according to the balance equation. What they are asking us is the volume of the residual gas. First, there are possible questions they can ask you from here. What is the excess reagent? Hydrogen. What is the limiting reagent? Oxygen, the one that is not enough. Now, the volume of the residual gas is the hydrogen remaining that did not react at all, and we got it to be 50 cm³, plus the product formed, 100 cm³. So 100 cm³, the product formed, plus the mass or the volume that did not react, is the volume of the residual gas, and that is 150 cm³. How many atoms are there in 1 mole of hydrogen gas? 1 mole of hydrogen gas. Look at it. This is hydrogen atom. Hydrogen gas, or hydrogen generally, it exists as molecule. You see that we say that chlorine is Cl, but in most equations, chlorine is like this, Cl2. Or we say oxygen atom is O, oxygen molecule is O2. One oxygen atom or one oxygen molecule, one O molecule, contains 2 atoms. One chlorine molecule, this is one chlorine molecule, it contains 2 chlorine atoms. Therefore, hydrogen gas or hydrogen molecule contains 2 atoms. And one atom contains Avogadro's number. So one atom of hydrogen contains Avogadro's number, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. 2 atoms of hydrogen gas is simply equal to 2 atoms of hydrogen. This will be 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 to give you 12.04 times 10 to the power of 24, or 1.2 times 10 to the power of 23. And the next question says, the mass of 800 cm³ of a gas at standard temperature and pressure is 1 kg. What is the molar mass of the gas? What is the molar mass of the gas? Look at it. V is equals 800 cm³. Now, the volume of any gas at standard temperature and pressure is supposed to be 22.4 dm³. The mass of this gas, mass, is equals 1 gram. So what is the molar mass? This is question. Since this gas is at standard temperature and pressure, we can say that the number of mole is equals volume over 22.4 dm³, which means this is in dm³, which means number of moles is equals, the volume we are given is 800 cm³. So 800 cm³ over, since we are given volume in dm³ and the volume here is in cm³, we need to convert this standard volume to cm³. How do we do that? We multiply by 1000. So this will give you 22400 cm³. To convert from dm cube to cm cube, you multiply by 1000. To multiply from cm cube to dm cube, you divide by 1000. In this case, we need the volume to be in cm cube, not dm cube. We divide by 1000. Here, we need the volume to be in dm cube, so we don't divide by 1000. In summary, at standard temperature and pressure, the number of moles is volume over 22.4 dm cube. And since the volume we are given is 800 cm cube, we convert this dm cube to cm cube to give us 22,400 cm cube. Number of mole therefore becomes 0.0357. Why did we look for number of mole? We are asked to look for molar mass. And number of moles is mass over molar mass. We have mass. Now we have number of moles. Molar mass is therefore equals mass over number of moles. That is 1/0.0357. So that will give you 28.0 grams per mole. This is the molar mass of the substance or of the gas Q. So ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the end of this episode. Open the Flashiness Jam app. Try to answer as many questions as possible on that chemical combination. You have any issue, chat me up and make sure you activate your copy of the app. Trust me, it will make you score very, very helpful. The app is as important as the video. Ladies and gentlemen, see you in episode 10, which is the final battle of chemical combination.